Today we are diving into an eye-catching circular animation with a colorful gradient glow. You have probably seen similar CSS effects on modern websites, app interfaces, or even social media posts. It's a visually appealing and creative way to enhance your designs. Hey everyone, this is Optimistic Web, where we explore the world of CSS and front-end development, one step at a time. In our HTML, we have a div element with a CSS class to work with, and inside, we have added an image to create a UI resembling a profile card. Our style sheet is already set up with foundational CSS for the page layout. Moving on to the topic of the day, we start by defining the circle CSS class and assigning it a width of 160 pixels. If you have been following along, you're probably familiar with the aspect ratio CSS property. I often use this to give an element a relative height. In this case, setting the aspect ratio to 1 ensures the height matches 100% of the width. Then, we use border radius to transform it into a perfect circle. After that, the image is styled with standard properties, including a width of 100% and the same aspect ratio, to ensure it fits within its parent element. Since our image has a different aspect ratio, it may appear squished. To fix this, we can set the object fit property to cover, so it maintains its proportional relationship between width and height. And then, setting the border radius to inherit allows it to adopt the same radius as its parent element. The inherit keyword instructs the element to take on the same value of that property from its parent. You might wonder why we didn't use inherit for the aspect ratio property. The simple answer is that it doesn't work consistently across browsers. Moving on, we will use the before pseudo element to create the colorful ring around our image. First, we set its position to absolute, add the content property with an empty string, inherit the border radius from its parent, and temporarily give it a red background so we can easily visualize it. I also need to mention the inset property. Similar to setting top, right, bottom, and left offsets, the inset property allows us to set all four offsets in a single declaration. In this example, inset 0 sets all four offsets simultaneously. To ensure the pseudo element is positioned relative to its parent, the parent element's position should be set to relative. Now we can use z-index -1 to send the pseudo element behind the image in the stacking context. Since it's completely hidden behind the image, we can fine-tune the inset property to adjust its size. Setting a negative value for the offsets will do the trick. And then we can replace the plain red background with a visually appealing conic gradient. To better understand how conic gradients work, let's temporarily disable the z-index. A conic gradient is similar to a color wheel within a circle. It creates a smooth transition between colors, starting from one point and ending at another. In this example, the first color begins at 0%, and the second color ends at 100% of the circle's circumference. These colors seamlessly blend together at the midpoint of the wheel, forming a harmonious transition. To create a conic gradient, we must specify at least two colors, but there's no upper limit. You can add as many colors as you like. Additionally, you can customize their starting and ending positions. In this updated version, the first color ends at 25%, the second at 50%, and the final color at 100%. As you might notice, there's a sharp transition between the first and last colors. We can smooth this out by adding a duplicate of the first color at the end of the color wheel. If you're interested in learning more about CSS gradients, I recommend checking out my detailed video on creating seamless CSS patterns. Returning to our design, let's simplify the colors to match our design guidelines and reapply the z-index. To create the glowing effect, we will use the after pseudo element to create an exact copy of the before pseudo element. The only difference is that we will add a blur filter to achieve the desired glow effect. We can then adjust its opacity to make it less prominent. Our design is almost complete, but we still need to add inner circles. There are various methods to achieve this, but the simplest solution in this case is to use the outline property. Here we add an outline of 30 pixels with a semi-transparent black color. Setting its offset to -12 pixels adds depth to the design. You can experiment with different values to achieve the look that best suits your needs. Finally, it's time to add the animation. The animation shorthand property specifies the name, which is rotate in this case. The duration is set to 3 seconds. The timing function is defined as linear, and the iteration count is set to infinite to ensure the animation runs continuously. Next, we define the waypoints using the @keyframes rule. This will rotate both pseudo elements from 0 degrees to 360 degrees, completing a full circle in 3 seconds. Since there is no change in the starting position, we can simply omit the first block. If you want to interact with the animating component, you can use the animation playstate property to pause the animation in the hover state for a better user experience. And that's how you can create eye-catching effects with a touch of creativity and a willingness to think outside the box. Sometimes, the most impactful effects come from simple techniques. Remember, the best designs often come from experimenting and pushing the boundaries of what's possible with CSS. Keep exploring, and don't be afraid to try new ideas to make your projects stand out. If you enjoyed this tutorial, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more front-end development tips and tricks. Feel free to leave your questions or comments below. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.